Good morning, everyone. I'm Dr. Shweta, Associate Consultant, Department of Pediatrics, Apollo Hospital, Bannerghatta Road. I hope all of you are keeping safe in this unvisioned time of the pandemic. During this tough time, caring for our little one is always a challenge. How much to do, what to do for the immunity is always a concern. So here I am to talk to you about some of the immunity boosting ways for your little one. Silver lining to this pandemic is that we have noted that less than 5% of the children of the population who get COVID-19 are children, and among the children, less than 1% experience severe illness and require hospitalization. This is maybe because child-to-child transmission of COVID is unlikely, but the only concern here is that they are silent carriers and they tend to give infection to the high-risk people. So what to do in this pandemic? As you all are aware of some of the general measures of sanitization of the hands, I'll just go through it very quickly. So make sure you sanitize your hands regularly with more than 70% alcohol and for a duration of 20 seconds. Please make it fun time with your child and probably sing a song for 20 seconds to make the experience better. The next method is by use of mask. Any kind of mask is alright, but whenever you step out of the house, please wear a well-fitted mask. Use of mask in children less than 2 years of age is not advised due to the risk of choking. Third way is social distancing. Kindly maintain more than 1 meter distance whenever you step out, especially in a crowded or a covered place. Another step is by sanitization of your surroundings. When it is a large surface, kindly sanitize with 0.5% sodium hypochlorite solution. You can prepare that at home by using half a teaspoon of bleaching powder in 1 liter of water. That is for bigger surfaces, and for smaller surfaces, please use the regular alcohol-based sanitizers. Now coming to what to do with the immunity, which is our topic for discussion today. So as you all are aware, the way to improve our immunity is mainly by diet. So what to give our children? If I say give vitamin A, B, C, D, E, and micronutrients like zinc, iron, copper, magnesium, selenium, folate, omega-3, omega-6, fatty acids, essential fatty acids, and lot of proteins, I'm sure none of you will understand anything. So just to tell you what foods give you what, you can use fruits like papaya, guava, apple, grapes, mango, which are rich in vitamin A, C, B, potassium and folate. Then coming to citrus fruits like orange, sweet lime, gooseberries, they are rich in vitamin C. Green leafy vegetables, broccoli, beans, mushrooms, bell peppers, they are very rich in beta carotene, vitamin C, E and antioxidants. Legumes, which are main part of the diet, including chickpeas, green grams, lentils, black grams, they are all rich in iron and zinc. Millets are a basic portion of the diet, which includes rice, jowar, ragi, whatever you are using as your basic diet, they are rich in micronutrients and fibers. Meat, please use lean meat. It is rich in iron, zinc and essential amino acids. Fish is rich in protein, vitamin A, E and essential amino acids. Also, you can add foods like yogurts and fermented foods like the batter, which is used for idli and dosa. So they act as superfoods. Now, what are superfoods? Superfoods are stuff which increase the good bacteria in the gut and also reduce the inflammatory process. So apart from the fermented foods, the superfoods that are known very well known in our Indian recipes like cumin, pepper, ginger, garlic and turmeric. So kindly use all this in your regular cooking. So now that I have told you what is rich in what, how do you use that in your diet? So if you take a plate and divide the plate into four parts, 1/4 of the plate constitutes the regular rice or chapati or ragi, that is the cereals, and 1/4 constitute the pulses, and more than 1/4 constitute the vegetables, which I have already discussed with you, and the remaining goes for the fruits. And please don't forget to add 2 to 3 glasses of milk. Milk can be given plain, or you can add some protein rich supplements into it, which are easily available in the market as flavored drinks. So apart from this, as I was talking about the superfoods like turmeric, cumin and all that, so on the website of Ministry of Ayush, there is a list of ways that you can use these foods. So you, whoever is interested, can go through that. And along with that, they also recommend using Chyawanprash and herbal tea. So recipe, all that is available on the website, so you can go through it. So apart from that, is there a need to take any supplements? Well, I would say you can use vitamin D supplement on a regular diet for all children. As you know that we all Indians are very deficient in vitamin D. So on a daily routine, you can use about 600 to 1000 IU per day of vitamin D. Also because we are not going out adequately into the sun. And need for multivitamin or zinc supplement, not really needed on a routine basis. But children who have premorbidities or are low weight for their age need to take some multivitamin supplements. So what else is need to be done to improve the immunity apart from the diet? Sleep. So regular sleep, sound sleep of 8 to 10 hours for the children is very important to improve the immunity. And physical activity, 1/2 hour physical activity per day and 5 days a week is very important. So you can make it a fun affair for the whole family. Please fix a time. All the family members gather around at the same time, and you can either dance or do some exercise, do yoga, pranayama, whatever, and make it a thing that the child looks forward to. So that way you can improve the immunity. Hydration. So a child weighing about 20 kg needs to take about 1.5 liters of water. Water need not be just plain water. You can also use tender coconut water, milk, buttermilk, or fruit juices if you're using, please use it without sugar. Then coming to the most important aspect, which is the mental health. So how do you ensure good mental health during this stressful time? As you all are going through a stressful time, your little ones are also going through tough times. So most essential thing is listen to them. Talk to them, comfort them, and reassure them that things will be all right. And probably you can sit together and meditate to maintain peace at home. Then some of the general measures I would like to highlight. Please use, please maintain a smokeless environment at home. Do not use alcohol and consume less junk food. Coming to other medications for a child who has premorbidities, please continue your regular medication and continue to consult with your doctor for the same. Do not skip your visits because of the pandemic. Now coming to what else has to be done. The most important thing is vaccination. So post the pandemic, the world would enter a phase where we will be facing the vaccine preventable disease outbreak. This is because it has been known that the number of visits to the hospital for vaccination has drastically come down during the COVID times. So ensure that you check your child's vaccine chart and go back to your pediatrician and complete the vaccination. Please check whether the primary vaccinations of DPT, measles, polio has been complete. Also, there is a special emphasis on the use of influenza vaccination and pneumococcal vaccination during the COVID times. It is noted that there is in presence of a co-infection of a bacteria or a virus along with the COVID increases the risk of severe illness. So kindly make sure your child is vaccinated for the same. So that covers most of the aspects of immunity boosting. So if you have any queries, please contact Department of Pediatrics at Apollo Hospital. Until then, keep safe and stay at home. Thank you.